Hey everyone, what's up? This is my step-by-step tutorial on how to make a custom email signature you can use for school or work. It'll impress anyone. So let's get started by creating a blank document on Google Docs. Also do this on Microsoft Word if you like. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to Insert, Table, and do a 2x1 table. Now, this left side is going to be one half of the content or one third, and the right side is going to be the other half. We will make this table invisible later on. So, I'm going to start by typing my name. It's important to remember that Gmail only supports certain fonts, so you might need to change them at the end. I'm using Open Sans because Google supports this one. It's nice and modern and it's clean. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start typing my name. I put my name in bold, and then I'm going to put my title down below, but I'm also going to change the color and change the spacing. So instead of single spacing, I'm going to do, let's try 1.15 and see how that looks. So we're going to do a gray color as well. All right, so now we pretty much have our email signature. What you can do is you can add some icons or you can add some links. Like let's do LinkedIn. So you can do just text like this, and then you're gonna right click, open link, and then do your LinkedIn profile. Mine is linkedin.com/in/ConnorRipple. And whenever users click on that, it'll take them directly to your LinkedIn page. What you can do is also edit the appearance of the link. So if you don't want that blue hyperlink, you can also do that. If you wanted to add icons, here's how you can do that. Let's take a look at some LinkedIn icons that we can use. So I just Googled LinkedIn icon PNG, and I'm gonna go over to Tools, Color, Transparent. I just wanna make it clear that some of these are subject to copyright, so make sure not to get into any trouble, but I'm gonna right click and do Save Image As, and make sure that the file type is PNG. If it says JPEG or something else, like it won't save properly. You can name it whatever you want. I prefer to stay organized, so I'm gonna do LinkedIn icon transparent. I might have spelled that wrong, but it's downloaded. Perfect. So now we're gonna open up Finder and we're gonna insert the picture here. Side note, and this is really important, if you want to do black icons, make sure to include a white background behind it. Otherwise, people with dark mode won't be able to see the icons. For an alternative that works with light mode and dark mode, feel free to use gray icons. Okay, so I'm going to create a new line and I'm going to insert an image. We're going to do upload from computer. And then what we're going to do is we're going to do the image that we just downloaded. This one. Select it from your Finder, and here it is. So basically, make sure it's selected under inline. If it's any of these things, Google won't let you add a link. So it must be inline. What we're going to do next is add a link. There we go. Now we have our link, and what I can do is I can make this smaller. I can put it to any size that I like, and this looks great. What I can do is add text right next to it, or what I can do is add three icons right next to each other. I'll show you how to do that next. Let's look for another icon. This time I'm going to do Instagram. Make sure you choose the right one because some of these are very weird looking, and save it in a folder where you can access it later just in case you might want to edit your email signature later on. Take this LinkedIn icon, and what you're going to do is copy it and then paste it. Right click again and select paste, and then there it is. So what we're going to do is select the new icon that we just copy and pasted, and we're going to use the tool at the top called replace image. So I'm going to upload from computer, and then I'm going to choose the Instagram icon. When we do this, it allows us to create two icons that are the exact same size. But what we're going to need to do now with this icon is right click and add our Instagram link. Make sure all your links are correct. What we can also do is we can add that sort of dividing line and then add an Instagram link. Press apply. Perfect. I just wanted to encourage you to Google email signatures to get some inspiration. You don't have to do one that looks exactly like what I do. Feel free to do one that matches your personal style or your brand style. There's so many different ways of doing them, so I encourage you to explore and try your own design. If you wanted to do a circular image on the left, like mine, I'm gonna show you how to do this. So what you're going to do is you're gonna go over to this website. The link is right here. crop-circle.imageonline.co. It's free, you can upload your image and position it where my face is in the center. So we're gonna press crop circle again. This is a little bit better, and we're gonna press download image. Select this left side of the table and go to insert, image. Perfect, so make it a little bit smaller so it'll fit. But notice how it's stuck on the right side. That's okay. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take the table and squeeze it over that way. It'd be best to just have it centered. Let's say you didn't have access to that tool or you wanted to do a rectangle shape instead. Well, what you could do is you could go to insert and upload a regular rectangle. Let's say you have these really weird underlines right there that you don't want. What you can do is just select the whole line, click the underline tool, and then click it again, and then that'll go away and you won't have that issue anymore. Let's say you wanted to do the three icons underneath the profile picture, like the one listed on my website. Here's how you can do that. It's directly below the profile photos. So we're just going to paste them like this. The thing is, these are too large. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to make them all really small. Basically, copy and paste them over here and make sure each individual one still has inline selected and each individual one is center aligned. All right, so here's how to prepare your email signature so you can copy and paste it into your mail provider. What you're going to do is you're going to select each side of the border and go over to border width and put 0. That way it'll make it invisible. So you can select multiple at the same time by holding the shift key and clicking on all the ones that you want to get rid of. Go over here and change it to 0. And here comes the most exciting part where we get to copy and paste this into Gmail so we can start using it. So what you're going to do is you're going to select this whole thing by clicking above it and clicking and dragging while holding the mouse. What we're going to do next is we're going to go over to all settings in Gmail, scroll down to signature and create a new signature. Go ahead and give your signature a name. And then what we're going to do is we're going to copy and paste what we just made. And make sure that the formatting is all correct. Thankfully, we did it right. I want this to be one line, so I'm gonna change it just to com. And then what we also might wanna do is underline this. You can also do that if you like. Make any final changes. And what you can do is scroll down to the bottom once you're done and press save changes. Okay, so here's how to include your email signature whenever you send an email to someone. So go to this pen icon and include signature one, and there it is. What you can do is it automatically adds these two dashes. You can just delete those, write your email, and send it. And we're gonna see how it looks on my iPhone just to make sure that it works. Subject line. All right, so I sent some test emails and look at this notification right here. This means that Gmail is recognizing the email signature as text, so it's not just an image, which is a good thing because sometimes your profile image might not load if someone's email blocks it. Let's take a look at the second issue. You might have issues if someone is using dark mode, so you might want to do some lighter gray icons or include some white behind the icons. That way people can see it regardless of light mode or dark mode. However, on light mode, on the right, this is Gmail, and then this is the mail app. They both look great. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please subscribe because I'm gonna release some more resume templates and some more email templates for you to use. Make sure you don't miss out on those. Lastly, if you're having any issues, I'll be checking the comments, so make sure to comment and ask if you have any questions, or if you have a suggestion that other people can do, make sure to comment that down below so other people can see it as well. Please make sure you're following my TikTok page in the description so you can stay updated on everything I'm doing, and I hope you have an awesome day.